wealthy Nigerian politician, his wife and a corrupt doctor are behind bars tonight after being found guilty of a shocking and elaborate organ harvesting plot. Ike Akweremadu and his wife Beatrice trafficked a vulnerable street trader from Lagos to London with a promise of money. They wanted to take one of his kidneys to transplant into their sick daughter. When medics at London's Royal Free Hospital rejected him, the plot began to unravel. Police praised the victim's bravery today in coming forward to help secure the convictions. All three defendants are facing a maximum life sentence under modern slavery laws. Ellie Pitt has more.
When this 21-year-old man walked into a Surrey police station last year crying and in distress, it was the start of an investigation into an alleged plot to harvest his organ.
That will not be intimidated by any circumstance.
Today, Senator Ike Akweremadu, a powerful and wealthy politician in Nigeria, has been convicted of conspiring to arrange the travel of a young man with a view to exploiting him for his body part. Found guilty of the same charge this morning was the senator's wife, Beatrice, and a medical middleman they used, Dr. Abina Abeta.
This is the first conviction of its kind in the UK. We could not have achieved this without the courage of one person, our victim survivor. I want to commend him for his bravery in speaking out.
The Old Bailey heard how the victim, a street trader from Lagos, was offered £7,000 to come to the UK and promised a new life here. But the real plan, the jury was told, was that he would donate his kidney to the Akweremadu's daughter Sonia, seen here at the front, who has a serious kidney condition. It's not illegal to donate a kidney, but it becomes criminal if there is a reward of money. They were pictured together before the proposed operation. He can't be identified for legal reasons. Today, Sonia Akweremadu cried in court as she was cleared by the jury. The alleged plan hit problems when the Akweremadus took the 21-year-old to start the transplant process.
The court heard how the victim came to this London hospital and that he didn't understand why he'd been brought to the UK until he met a doctor here. That doctor said the young man was not an appropriate donor because he hadn't had any advice about the risks of surgery and didn't have the funds he'd need for lifelong care. So the operation was refused.
The jury was told the Akweremadus then continued the search for a donor, and this was when the victim was able to escape. Today, his lawyer in Nigeria explained how his client's life has been changed forever.
Certainly, with these things, he can't go back to who he used to be. He can't come to Nigeria freely, obviously. He cannot walk the streets of Nigeria. The cheerful part of it is that he's excited, that he was able to stand up for himself.
And this decision to do that and seek help from the police has now created a historic legal precedent.
And that's because this is the first case where a conviction has been secured using the organ harvesting element of the Modern Slavery Act, a relatively new piece of legislation brought in 2015. But prosecutors have been criticised for the lack of convictions they've secured under it. Ike Akweremadu, Beatrice Akweremadu and Obina Obeta will be sentenced on the 5th of May.
OK, Ellie Pitts outside the Old Bailey, thank you.